Good evening, my brothers and sisters. We are thanking God through our reading for today because nung panahon na nagsisimula yung breaths, wala tayong vespers dati. Liturgy of the hours lang natin every Sunday, mid-afternoon. Every Sunday lang ang liturgy of the hours natin, and we don't see each other during the week. So actually, ang response natin kay Lord during that time in 1999 is to fill in the need of the church. Kulang ang walang masyadong nagsaserve noon na kabataan dito sa Baguio Cathedral. Wala pa yung chapel na yan, and tayo lang yung youth group noon dito. The way I see it. And that's why we were by the hundreds. Ang dami-dami nating members noon. And they were responding to the call of God at least once a week. We see each other, the leaders see each other Friday nights. And then we meet the members on Saturdays for preparation for Sunday services. So yun ang life natin noon. And tayo lang ang choir noon dito, aside from the Baguio Cathedral Choir. We are serving here in the services. 5 p.m. pa rin ang service natin. Ang Sunday services natin, 2 to 3, we adore the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament with a rosary and this liturgy of the hours before the Mass. So we practice our music 3 to 5 before we serve the in the Mass at 5 p.m. So that was our life before. Until such time, kasi ang mga singers doon dito were cantors lang from 6 p.m. hanggang 6 p.m. 6 to 6 ang Mass noon dito. Cantors lang. Ang may choir lang yung 4 p.m. at saka 5 p.m. tayo. So I'm happy that through the years, we have inspired other young people to come up with their own choirs. Until such time na, kung napapansin ninyo, pag nagmamas kayo, bihira na lang ang cantors. Lahat halos ay choirs na. So this is one inspiration that we have contributed in the church since we are filling in the need. We are not here to compete with other people, but we are here to complete what is lacking in the service of the church. So, kanina, tinitignan ko tayo that suddenly we have these vespers that we are doing daily from Mondays to Fridays. Hanggat kaya natin. And this is also another response to the need of the times. Kasi ang kailangan talaga natin ngayon is prayers. With what is happening with the world today, especially in our country, we are being bombarded by Western culture and the culture of greed and the culture of death and the culture of evil and also the culture of a godless society. So we need more prayers. Kasi kapag, if we do not pray, we will start to lose the sense of God. And if we lose the sense of God, we will lose the sense of sin, as if everything is relative. Kaya ito yung malakas na pumapatay ngayon sa faith ng Europe, the culture of relativism. And since Europe was founded on Christianity, yung constitution nila, wala doon yung history nila. They forgot that Europe came about through Christianity. It was evangelized, that's why. Kasi noon, wala pang nations noon eh. Puro kingdoms lang noon. So whoever invented the nations started to divide us. And sabi nga ni Pope John Paul II, the nations, the so-called United Nations, in the end, will divide the body of Christ. So ang target natin ngayon bilang Kristiyano is to bring together the people into one in Christ. Ito yung mission natin. By virtue of our baptism, tayo na-baptize tayo, our mission is to proclaim the word of God and to bring souls to Christ the King, to bring his people back in as one in him. So ito po yung mission natin. So araw-araw makikita natin, hindi naman natin siguro kakayanin na mag-isa natin to, but at least in the 24 hours that God gives us each day, at least there's one moment there that we have brought a soul to Christ. Meron sana tayong na-inspire, meron sana tayong through our life, knowingly or unknowingly, that somebody has remembered Christ because of us. And I remember one king na kasi hari siya, pero hindi siya prayerful. But nakikita niya sa tao, kapag sila nagdadasal, mas umaayos yung kanyang kingdom. So alam niyo ang ginawa niya, he displayed his rosary. He displayed his rosary every day, wherever he goes. And because of this rosary, people remember God. And they pray the rosary. When the king in fact doesn't pray, hindi niya alam dasalin yung rosary, pero nakita niya sa mga tao that they have this devotion to Mama Mary through the rosary. So with this little example that the king did, it converted or it brought his people to God. No? They have responded because he is a king and he has influence. So tayo din, there must be something in us that should bring a soul. Tulad natin, nagkikwintas tayo ng cross, nagkikwintas tayo ng Santo Niño, nagkikwintas tayo ng Mama Mary, or nagpe-praise tayo ng rosary, or we have a rosary, or our tawag nito, scapular. So these are signs of the presence of God in us, that tayo, hindi tayo mawala, kahit tayo mismo sa ating sarili, we need signs and symbols for us to be reminded of the presence of God. That's why sabi dito, napakaganda ng reading, no? Na sabi niya, if you read the reading, sabi dito, let the word of Christ, rich as it is, dwell in you. Yung salita ng Panginoon, rich as it is, dwells in us. How will it dwell in us? By living it. By proclaiming it. And what more? In wisdom made perfect, instruct and admonish one another. So, hopefully, our sharing here is admonishing, hopefully, and instructing each other into the way of God. We are not just here to feed our minds with the thoughts of Christ, but to help us be moved into living a better life. And one more thing, as I look at the whole church, ito yung ginagawa ng simbahan natin. Kaya niya ina-admonish yung mga lawmakers natin, yung mga senators natin, yung ating mahal na presidente, upang huwag naman basta-bastang gumawa ng hakbang na makakasira sa kultura ng Pilipino. Tulad na lang ng RH Bill. That's why maraming umuoo sa RH Bill without even knowing it. Bakit tayo umuoo without even knowing it? Sana umaayaw tayo dahil hindi natin alam kung ano yun. Marami kasing tao, kanina may nabinti naman tayong tao na nagkukwento that some of her friends are saying yes to the RH Bill without even knowing the RH Bill. When in fact, we should not say no to something that we do not know, di ba? Mag-oo ba tayo sa isang bagay na hindi natin alam kung ano yun? I don't think so. If you are being served food na hindi mo alam, will you eat it? Kasi hindi mo alam kung anong lasa nun, anong pagkain yun, anong klaseng pagkain yun. Ito ang nangyayari sa atin sa RH Bill. You know that the RH Bill has been lobbied or laging ipinapasok sa Kongreso yan for many times over na, ibang pangalan. I think more than 200 times nang pinasok yan as a bill sa Congress. Ito ang nangyayari sa atin ngayon. Para tayong, we are like frogs or palaka. Nakakita na kayo ng palaka?
Yung palaka, kapag inilagay mo yan sa kumukulong tubig, pag nilagay mo yan sa kumukulong tubig, makakatalon pa yun eh. Makakatakas pa siya. Kung makakatakas siya sa kumukulong tubig, kasi kumukulo yun eh. Pero ang problema doon sa palaka, ilagay mo yun sa malamig na tubig, tapos yung tubig na yun, isalang mo sa kalan, switch mo, unti-unti siya kumiinit. Diba? Hanggang sa hindi niya alam, naluto na pala siya. Hindi na siya makakatakas dahil bigla na lang, naluto na lang siya. Yun ang nangyayari sa atin. We are being slowly desensitized until such time that we just say yes to anything that comes our way. Being a Christian, we should be discerning of the threats to our culture and threats to our faith. Even if, halimbawa sa isang opisina, kahit na yes na sila lahat, eh, you should stand up for saying no also. Be critical. Sa school, kumisat kasi, tulad ko, no, I spoke sa NSTP ng SLU. There are thousands of them. There were thousands of them. Eh, pro-life. I am part of the pro-life board of directors. So, pro-life kami, nag-present kami tungkol sa pro-life. After that, yung Q&A, yung questions and answers, mapapansin mo doon, pagtanong ng isang estudyante, biglang uugong yung, ano, yung gym na they are favoring this their student, their classmate, because yung tono ng pagtanong ng classmate is parang this person is going against the pro-life principles. So makikita mo na doon ang trend ng pag-iisip ng mga kabataan is going towards this RHB without even knowing it. Hindi ba? So, parang nakakalungkot. But, nung nandoon ako, hindi sana ako speaker doon. May dalawang speakers. Pero, nung naku-corner na sila, hindi naman sa marami kong alam, but parang sabi, I have to speak. And I spoke to them with what I know about the RH bill. Kasi yung RH bill, within this week, aapurahin nila eh, that hinahabol nila by Friday, maaaprubahan na. Kasi magkakaroon ng bakasyon ang Congress, papasok sila after 1 month pa. So hinahabol nila maaaprubahan na ngayon. So I don't think this is something good for us na ang isang bill, aapurahin na hindi pinag-aaralan ng gusto. Bakit ang simbahan ay ganun na lang siyang kumukontra dito? Kasi nakalagay dito sa Biblia eh. In wisdom made perfect, instruct and admonish one another. I believe that the church today, represented by men, were inspired by God. Sabi kasi sa Matthew, you are Peter, you are a rock, and upon this rock, I will build my church, and even the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. So ibig sabihin, the church is being guided by the Holy Spirit since Jesus Christ founded it until now, through the Pope, through our clergy, through the magisterium of the church. And I believe that the church will not teach us error. Through the years, nalinis na yung simbahan natin, and wisdom is made perfect through thousands of years of the presence of our church. And here comes something, a bill that will promote contraceptives. Ang problema dito sa contraceptive mentality natin, if the contraceptives will fail, next is abortion. After the abortion bill, what is next? Divorce bill. What after divorce bill? Same-sex unions. So these are against the future of our young people. Sinong magiging biktima ng mga bills nito? Kayo. That's why we have to pray for our lawmakers. We have to pray for our leaders, that yung minds na open. Kaya nga yung indoctrination of children, as young as grade 3, tuturuan na ng, i-indoctrinahan na ng RH Bill. Can you imagine that? They will teach, you will destroy the innocence of a young person just because of greed, just because we are protecting a nation's interests or a foreign nation's interests. Actually, kaya kung mga kapatid, kung hindi natin alam, let us not say yes. Kung hindi natin alam, let us say no. And let us be standing firm against this. Because the church is saying so. Merong isang matanda na, illiterate, na simba ng simba. Kinanong siya ng isang non-Christian. Bakit ka ba simba ng simba dyan? Bakit ka ba nagdadasal? Parang tinatanong doon sa matanda. Sabi ng matanda, siguro, sabi niya, nauna na yung mga santo noon pa. Nasagot na siguro yung mga tanong na yan. Ako, sumusunod na lang. This is faith. This is faith. Kaya mga kapatid, there is an enemy that we cannot see. The evil is dividing us as a nation because of this bill. One thing, let us stand up for the truth. Yung katotohanan pinanas natin. That's why, dito sa readings natin, let us continue to pray. Maybe what we can do is to pray. Kasi, isang point, if you go to the missions, you are doing things for God. Right? But if you are praying, God will do it for you. This is a sign of our humility. This is our sign of surrender to God. And we are fighting for our faith. We are fighting for life. Let God do the rest. Let's do our part in cooperating with God's plan. Because we are men and women of peace, let Christ's peace reign in our hearts. Since as members of the one body, we have been called to that.